Hey guys, appreciate you tuning into my YouTube channel. This week has all been about buck sweep. And I hope you can take these principles, especially the ones I'm about to talk about the next couple days, and you can apply them to any run you want to, because all we're doing is we're building in answers to problems. And this, the next couple days, we're gonna be talking about backside problems. If you're interested, you can go back through this section of videos and watch play side issues, nine technique, nose, linebacker, and then numbering. If you want to see the different answers, potential answers, you can go through and look at those. From here forward, we're going to look at how we answer problems coming off of the backside. Okay, so we are the gun T RPO offense, which means we are trying to RPO, run pass option, or read different things on the backside as solutions to problems. Okay, if you want my whole system, it's available. You can go get the playbook, fbcoachsimpson.com. Or you can go to CoachTube and you can see all the different ways we run it with game film and all that kind of stuff. But today we're going to talk about backside, inside linebacker and different potential RPOs you can do to take advantage of this kid. Okay, so what I'm talking about is we're going to run buck sweep to the play side, which will be this direction. So backside issues or anything from this part of the center over our backside issues. So today we're talking about inside linebacker. Tomorrow we'll talk about the outside linebacker, talking about defensive lineman that's an interior defensive lineman, and then defensive lineman that's an exterior defensive lineman, all built in with the RPOs, okay? So inside linebacker is the guy that is a problem for us. As we're game planning a team, we typically will look at who has the most tackles, who's the most talented kid, and then of course you're gonna confirm that in the first drive or two of the game as you're calling plays. But once you've identified this is a problem, and when you run the buck, that position naturally is a problem because you're trying to wrap a guard through and find it, or you're trying to have a lineman kind of sort through the mess to find it. So it's not an easy block, okay? So we need to have a potential answer for that player. So we can do two different RPOs on this guy. We can do a true run pass option, or we can do a run option with our quarterback. And so I'll go through the first one first, which the last couple of years we've called key. Now that I'm doing all these information deals, we'll probably have a different tag for it in the upcoming season, but the premise will be the same. Okay, so we can run the ball on buck and run some type of fast or some type of bubble or some type of quick passing game out here to occupy the backside, outside linebacker, and the corner. And sometimes they'll even occupy the safety depending on what they're reading. And then we're going to read him on a run option. We used to call that key. So that meant we're keying or reading this player. As this guard pulls to wrap, if he takes off to make the tackle, then the quarterback will pull the ball out of the belly of the running back and he'll attack that space. Depending on what happens here with a strong or quick tackle, that could hit, usually we want it to hit inside, but it may hit right outside that guy as we're going. And if your quarterback is very talented, you can do the whole triple option deal where after he pulls and runs, now he can read this outside linebacker and still throw the screen if he wants to throw it. So that's one way to handle backside inside linebacker with a run only or more of a triple option type look. Perhaps you don't want to run your quarterback, which a lot of people don't want to run. So we run on that, what we would call peak, or we've called it spot before. I'm sure we'll have a term for it this year as well. So we'll take our slot receiver and bring him into the void right here. We don't ever want him to stop. I don't like him sitting down. I want to keep him moving. It just seems that it'd be better with timing, and then once he catches it, he's already kind of moving to where you want him to move. So the quarterback will read the same player, but now instead of pulling to run, he's going to pull to throw. And we can do this out of twins, we can do this out of trips, we can do this out of a single. You know, if we're gonna run it another way, we just tag it and run it to a different player. So we can run it out of trips to the inside guy, trips to the middle guy. If we wanted to, I don't know why we would, we could run it with trips to the outside guy. We just tag it within our terminology, okay? But all we're doing is reading the same player. If he bites, we pull and we throw. And you have, that's probably the first YouTube video I put out was buck sweep with the peak behind it. But that's where the theory for all that stuff came from. Is this is a backside issue, how are we going to answer it? Again, if you want more detail with game film, with me walking through, drawing it up, everything you might possibly want, you can go to fbcoachsimpson.com and get my playbook, or you can go to CoachTube and actually go through the entire Buck Sweep course. Most people that have watched it have really enjoyed it. I appreciate your time. If you don't mind, I'd love to get my numbers up on subscribers. All you gotta do is click a button below. Appreciate it. Thank you.